Hello students, myself Dr. Sneha Bhatia, MPT in Orthopedics and Sports Rehabilitation, in charge principal at Leeds Srimati S.G. Patel Institute of Physiotherapy. Today my lecture will be on physiotherapy exercises for osteoarthritis of knee joint. So these are the exercises which we can ask our patients to do for the OA knee. First one is static quadriceps. Patient will be in supine position or in long sitting position. Give a bolster underneath the knee joint. Ask the patient to press the knee joint and hold it for 5 to 10 seconds and then they can relax it. 10 repetitions can be done for 3 sets and total of 30 times patient can do this exercise. Same for the static hamstring. Ask the patient to press the heel on the couch and hold it for 5 to 10 seconds and then they can relax it. Again 10 repetitions for 3 sets it can be done. Short arcs. Put a bolster underneath the knee joint and ask the patient to raise the heel from the couch and then the patient can hold that leg in the air for 5 to 10 seconds and then they can keep it down. Patient can do straight leg raise, that is in the supine position patient will be asked to lift the leg from the couch and then hold it for 5 to 10 seconds and then keep it down. Hip abduction and adduction can be done in supine position. Heel slides can be done in the supine position. Ankle toe movement, ask the patient to do ankle dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Daily 2 to 3 sessions of physiotherapy can be done for the patient. So this is the image showing straight leg raises. Second is hamstring stretch. So in supine position, ask the patient to raise the leg, hold the stretching position for up to 30 seconds and it can be repeated for 5 times. So when the question is asked in your examination for 15 marks that write the assessment and management of osteoarthritis of the knee joint, everyone will be writing the exercises, but how can you get more marks in your examination? So the answer is draw stick diagram. Whenever you are asked PT assessment and management of a particular disease, you should try and draw as many stick diagrams as possible. That will help you to get more marks in your examination. So whatever exercises I am giving in this PPT, you can try to make stick diagram for each and every exercise. So exercises for OA knee in lying position, that is hip abduction and adduction, 10 repetition can be done and 3 sets can be done. Rest period should be given in between the sets and hip abductor strengthening plays important role to decrease pain and to improve quality of life. Exercise for OA knee in long sitting position, as you can see in the picture on the left side, patient will be in long sitting position and patient can do calf stretching. So stretch the calf muscles, hold it for 30 seconds and then release it. It can be done for total of 5 repetitions. Same way hamstring stretching can be performed. Ankle movements with crossing the leg so that the ankle of one side touches the knee of the opposite side. So as shown on the right side picture, patient can be in seated position and then they can perform ankle dorsiflexion, plantar flexion as well as ankle rotations. Next, exercises for OA knee in sitting position. Sitting at the edge of the couch and doing knee flexion and extension. Knee flexion should be performed to maintain the available range of motion and try to increase the range if it is restricted. So as shown on the left side picture, patient can be seated on the chair and he can do knee flexion exercises. To improve the knee extension, extend the knee completely and add ankle dorsiflexion at the end of the movement. So as shown on the picture on the right hand side, patient will be seated on the chair. Ask the patient to extend the knee joint and at the end of the range of motion, ask the patient to do ankle dorsiflexion. Circular movement of leg also can be done clockwise as well as anti-clockwise. So exercise for OA knee in the standing position, squatting can be done, partial squat can be done, heel raises, toe raises, standing knee flexion and extension also can be done. Standing hip abduction and adduction can be done. All these exercises can be done for 10 repetitions of 3 sets with rest periods in between. Next is great training. Walk normally for 15 to 20 minutes. Daily walking of 30 minutes or more is encouraged. Gradually increase the time duration of walking. Correct the gait abnormalities. Teach the correct gait pattern. Walk in parallel bar using the mirror. When we ask the patient to walk in the parallel bar, patient can have visual feedback. Patient can see in the mirror what mistakes they are making and they can correct the mistakes by themselves. If we are having the facility of treadmill in our OPD, then we can even ask the patient to walk on the treadmill. Next is stair climbing. Ascending and descending stairs can be done. If the patient is tired, then patient can take a rest and stop the exercises when the pain is increases. Mostly the patients of ONE, sometimes they will complain of knee pain when they are trying to do stair climbing. So if they are having pain, we can tell them to rest or we can do the stair climbing session later on when the pain decreases. Cycling, static cycling for 15 to 20 minutes. If the range is restricted, then half pedal can be done. Try to avoid the crepitus while cycling. Sometimes when the patients are performing the cycling, they will hear the crepitus. So the cycling can be performed in such a manner that the crepitus are minimal. Go at a comfortable speed. Keep the resistance as per the patient's capacity. Most of the static cycle will have the knob for the resistance. So the resistance can be set according to the patient's capability. Pain during the exercises. Take rest, take breaks while performing the exercises. So when the patient is having the pain while performing the exercises, we should ask the patient to take rest or to take break, because we are prescribing the exercises to the patient so their pain can come down, the pain should decrease. But while performing the exercises, if pain is increasing, then we have to tell the patient to take some rest. Restart when the pain decreases. In case of severe pain, stop the exercise session. Perform the exercise which increases the pain at the last. For example, suppose stair climbing is giving increased pain to the patient, then we should perform all other exercises at first and stair climbing can be done last during the physiotherapy session. Put ice pack for 20 minutes with compression after performing the exercises. This will help the patient to reduce their pain. So these are the references for today's video. So thank you so much for subscribing my channel. If you have enjoyed watching this video, then please like and subscribe my channel. I again want to thank all my seniors, juniors, my students, my colleagues and the faculty members who knows me for liking this channel and supporting me. So stop the spread of disease corona. What we can do to stop the spread of the disease? We can wash our hands. We should avoid going out. So this graph is showing that each and every country is having certain capacity of their healthcare facility. If the number of patients of COVID-19 is increasing to our capacity of healthcare system, then the system will crash down. So as a citizen of India, what we can do? We can wash our hands, we can work from home, we should avoid traveling, and together we can fight this disease. Thank you so much for watching this video.